professor and MC of Mahavir Hospital Manish IVF Center, Sai Baba USG Center. Many special awards and achievements are Dynamic Indian of Millennium by KG Foundation, Gynec Excellence Award by Foxy in 2020, is a commendable editor-in-chief by IESRF in 2021.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for kind words. Good morning, President Mukesh. Good morning, Mukesh Square. Good morning, sir. Pandar sir, pranam. Thank you for giving me opportunity to share my views on new paradigm in management of PPH. This is my credentials, and I will urge everybody to become a part of ORCID. ORCID is your 16-digit Aadhaar card. There are 87 presentations of mine in ORCID. Recently, I got MB recognized 2-seat for Diploma DGO up to 2027 and 2-seat for ICOG Fellowship in Reproductive Medicine and Laparoscopy. The moment child is born, mother is also born. She is there. Mother is something new, said by Ratnish Ji. With the blessings of mother of mine, 3 books written by us is recommended in Royal College as a reading material. Atlas Optical Echocardiography has gone for 2nd edition as well as IVF Made Easy, and I am editor-in-chief of 2 journals. Recently, I got chance to interview Professor Herman Tourne yesterday, 2023 at Copenhagen, and you can see all this video on Manish 4269 channel. What is the consequence of PPH? Why you want to discuss PPH? Because it is of heavy blood loss. It causes anemia, madam has rightly said, anemia. It causes prolonged hospital stay and sometimes matter. Recently, we see that one lady has committed suicide in Rajasthan because of PPH. So, a right and timely treatment can prevent a lot of complications. There are lots of different definitions are there of PPH. One is that is primary, blood loss of 500 ml, severe, blood loss of more than 1000 ml, late, that is after 24 hours. It basically depends upon the tolerance of blood loss in women. It blood loss often assessed via visual estimation and it is subjective. I would like the definition of FIGO. It says that define PPH as any blood loss that will potentially to produce hemodynamic instability. We all know there are different stages of labor. Sir, by definition, it is a series of events that occurs in woman's genital tract to expel out the viable product of conception from uterus via cervix through vagina with minimal side effect. That is first stage. We are not worried. But we are worried for this third stage of labor where we are delivering the placenta. During this third stage, the separation of placenta from uterine myometrium is critical stage. Bleeding is controlled usually by contraction and infection, and all the other figure of 8 ligature, that is natural ligature, are there. But if uterine atony is there, it causes failure of uterine smooth muscle fibers to contract and retract, and that is the major cause of PPH. And when this figure of 8 ligature are not working, it causes atony of the uterine musculature. We have to thank our mother that our mother has secreted enough amount of endogenous oxytocin. And if it is not, then we administer exogenous oxytocin, which causes myometrial cell membrane receptor and promotes influx of calcium from extracellular fluid and from sacroplasmic reticulum into the cell. And this increases the cytoplasmic calcium and stimulates uterine contraction. We see the maternal that are most prevalent in lower one-third or middle-income cases, particularly in India, if we are at the higher number of cases. But we see worldwide, hemorrhage is responsible for approximately one-third of direct obstetric death. If you see the number wise, 661,000 women had died between 2003 to 2009. And if you count minute, one death is there in every 6 minutes because of postpartum hemorrhage. We all know there are 4 different T's, tone, tissue, trauma and thrombin. But we are worried more for atony, that is stone, and it is the most commonest cause of PPH. It defined as failure of uterus to contract and retract. Several physical and pharmacological factors can affect uterine contraction. And the development of PPH may be correlated with the length of third stage of labor. What are the challenges in PPH? Usually we see there is delay in diagnosis. After delivery, we are at the home and there is a bleeding started. And sister says, Sai Bhavane, bleeding charged. So always there is delay in diagnosis. Many cases of PPH can occur without any identified risk factor. Visual estimation of blood loss of the volume and under and over estimation of blood. Somebody said it is less, somebody said it is very high. So there are several approaches can be increased with accuracy of visual estimation of blood, that is by calibrated grabs, weighing, petri dish, whatever, kidney tray, whatsoever that. But most important, it is there since 1967, it is a shock index. It may help in recognition of hemodynamic compromise. We all know whenever patient is in shock, there is tachycardia, there is hypotension. So SWOG index is described by heart rate divided by systolic blood pressure. Normal range is 0.5 to 0.7, but when it goes to less than one, more than 1.7, it causes woman needs urgent resuscitation. So in woman with blood loss of more than 1500 ml, the SWOG index is strong predictor for ICU admission and blood transfusion. We have got so many uterotonics in our armament, starting from oxytocin, methylangometrin, prostaglandin, misoprostol, and latest is carbetocin. It is recommended by POCSI PPH management in September 2022. WHO also recommends uterotonic as a carbetocin 100 mg when oxytocin is not available or we are not sure about the storage facility of oxytocin. Likewise, people is also said in setting where oxytocin is unavailable for its quality, cannot be guaranteed, the use of other uterotonics, that is carbetocin, ergometrin, misoprostol is recommended. So what is this carbetocin? It was created by making several modifications to the oxytocin structure. The carbetocin has similar onset of action as oxytocin because it is the sister, artificial intelligence sister of oxytocin, but it has got half-life, that is at least 6 times longer. Duration is more than 60 minutes, half-life is 33 minutes, we are giving IV, but if we are giving IM, half-life is 55 minutes and duration of action is 119 minutes. If you see compared to oxytocin, it is very high. So carbetocin is a carba analog, has prolonged activity and half-life due to deamination, which protects carbetocin from aminopeptide cleavage, and the replacement of sulfide bond by CH2S protects the analog from disulfide cleavage and also due to its lipotoxicity. Carbetocin is newer, longer-acting synthetic analog of oxytocin with agonist property. Carbetocin is available as room temperature formulation in India. It is room stable in India. We can store up to 40 degree for 6 months. We can store up to 30 degree. We don't have to keep in refrigerator and stable from 30 degree to 75% relative humidity for 36 months. How it is possible? Because it was available in cold chain, but they had added isotonic agent mannitol. pH adjustment was done with sodium hydroxide, and they put NC oxidants, L-methionine, and buffer used as succinic acid. This all structure make our carbetocin room temperature stable, that is RTS. What are the clinical trials for carbetocin? First trial was conducted in 2018. It was done on 350 patients with intervention of 100 microgram carbetocin on one arm, and competitor is 5 international unit of oxytocin. Outcome is rate of PPH. They found that less PPH and mean volume loss of blood with carbetocin versus oxytocin after vaginal birth in women at risk, it is very low. Likewise, there is less need of additional uterotonic with carbetocin versus oxytocin in women at the risk of PPH. You can see that additional use of another uterotonic is less required when used carbetocin. If you see the side effect between the carbetocin and oxytocin, it is almost same or some are negligible. So in conclusion, intravenous carbetocin is more effective than intravenous oxytocin for prevention of ectopic PPH among singleton pregnancy with at least one risk factor of PPH. Whatever Cochrane says as regarding the uterotonic agent, they have done study of different molecule up to 2018. Primary outcome was PPH and secondary outcome is listed above. They see that with carbetocin, up to 45 fewer cases of blood loss or more than 500 ml per 1000 women across all stillbirth compared with oxytocin. If you see, it is very less. Likewise, more than 1000, 5 fewer cases. If you compare oxytocin, carbetocin, ergometrin, misoprostol, misoprostol alone and injectable prostaglandins. This is very busy slide. But WHO recommends in Cochrane review, you can see all, it is probably superior compared to all different molecule available in market. If we compare oxytocin, carbetocin, misoprost and misoprostate oxytocin. If we are two drugs, it is equivocal with the carbetocin, but it has got probable superiority over another uterotonics available in market. Big trial had came in 2018, that is a champion trial. It was conducted on more than 29,645 cases in India. Bhubaneswar was one of the center in which the carbetocin champion trial was there. It was for the intervention of 100 microgram carbetocin, and outcome is composition of blood loss more than 500 ml or use of additional uterotonics. What they found? Non-inferiority was demonstrated for blood loss more than 500 ml or additional uterotonics. Non-inferiority is what very lovely, madam. When I started my paper on 2016, when we are comparing microresistor with dietrogestor, we are comparing a child in the market. Likewise, oxytocin was there since years together. So we have to compare that it is not equivocal, not superior, but it is not inferior. So So that is the carbetocin has got non-inferiority with the additional euterotonic. When you use carbetocin, it is stable and we don't have to use anything more. Likewise, same in 1000 ml of blood loss. And what they have concluded, that heat-stable carbetocin was non-inferior to 10 international units of oxytocin for blood loss more than 500 ml or additional use. Now, secondary and safety outcomes are comparable with the two drugs. If we see international consensus, what people want to use during uterotonic as a cesarean section, there are recommendations that oxytocin has got significant adverse effect when given as a rapid high-dose bolus. Number two, there is no proper dosage requirement. Somebody is giving 3 ampoules, somebody is giving 4 ampoules, somebody is giving 5 ampoules, somebody is not giving oxytocin. So there is no fixed regime to control the PPH. So infusion regimes are highly variable. While carbetocin is a fixed regime, and if you use it, oxytocin, cesarean section and normal labor, carbetocin is longer acting analog of oxytocin with similar mechanism of action and adverse effect. Increased duration of action of carbetocin compared with oxytocin eliminates the requirement of additional infusion after initial dose, and it may therefore become the preferred first-line drug rather than oxytocin. If we see that our anesthetists love to use this drug, then it is very good. This is the consensus or conclusion by anesthetists, that if we use carbetocin, there is less anesthesia required because there is less atonic PPH and no chances of PPH was there. So carbetocin is endorsed by various guidelines and it comes out with promise of effective, well-tolerated single dose, long-acting euterotonic with room temperature stabilization. This is carbetocin RTS indication we are using in cesarean section as well as in normal delivery. We can use the patient in general anesthesia as well as spinal anesthesia. We have to take 1 ml solution containing 100 microgram of duratocin and administer by intravenous injection or IM under adequate medical supervision. It must be administered after delivery of the baby, as soon as possible after delivery of baby and before the delivery of placenta. Intravenous of duratocin must be administered slowly, so easily administered, that you take 1 ml of duratocin and dilute in 1 ml of normal saline and give it very slowly. Duratocin room temperature stable is intended for single use, either you use IV or IM. There is no dose requirement after the first dose, and at any stage you can give this duratocin as a euterotonic agent. So there is no data on additional dose that we are not using. We are very happy with single dose. We cannot use on pregnancy, we cannot use as an induction of labor, we cannot use in diabetic and renal patients or severe vascular complications or epilepsy. So these are room temperature stable carbetocin, which is efficacious in vaginal as well as normal delivery. It gives very low rate of postpartum hemorrhage, decreases uterine massage. It is very good in blood loss, with controlling the blood loss, and significantly reduces the need for additional uterotonic, and if you compare the safety with same cardiac, right? WHO guideline 2018 also recommend oxytocin as the first and carbetocin as the second drug management. Room temperature carbetocin delivers efficacy with single dose, longer half-life of 140 minutes, proven safety, require no refrigeration and reduces need of additional uterotonic. This is 1 minute video of Pomo Kemchi. Everybody knows Pomo Kemchi is a very good. Just
this is stop the volume. Pomo Kemchi needle. Stay.
Everybody knows that this is Pomo. Just stop the volume. Stop the volume.
Pomo Kemchi needle from the angle. Stay.
So when they are talking about postpartum hemorrhage. Yes. Okay. Where is I'm here. I have to stop. Yes. Yes. So we know that in PPH, when we are dealing with PPH, we can use this. Secondly, there is an additional dose. We are using this as a control in hematoma. This is the second video. This video, you can see that we have used this needle to control the hematoma, which has occurred in the posterior segment. Now start the video.
We have used Pomo Kemchi needle, straight needle from here to here, and using rather as a brace, we have used
here there is a big hematoma
to control
from the angle.
We have passed second needle, curved needle from avascular area outside, and we have covered this hematoma with 1, 2, and 3 times. So now you can see hematoma has stopped. So this is another use of Pomo Kemchi needle to control angle.
So yesterday everybody had seen how Comochemistry is useful and it is very good thing. And recently I visited Bhilai and two residents had wanted to do dissertation on this Comochemistry, and Mahesh Gupta is ready to give free supply for the dissertation. So thank you, Mahesh. So men need these difficulties because they are necessary to enjoy the success. And because of my paper in 2016, so many companies have made GIF from my digestion. So thank you very much for patient hearing. This is time to be happy, and I am urging that everybody should vote for Sunita Tendulkar. She is going for FOCSI election. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Given a good comparison between oxytocin and vasopressin. I think all our doubts are now clear, and given a very good video presentation also.
Thank you.